Hi guys, I hope that you're all having a fabulous day. Welcome back to my channel. We talk about the good, we talk about the bad, now it's time to talk about the ugly. I asked you guys on my YouTube community page as well as on Instagram to share some of the ugliest or the most ridiculous luxury goods and contemporary items on the market right now, and man oh man, did you deliver. So that's what we're going to be discussing in today's video. I hope that you enjoy it. If you do, make sure and give it a thumbs up. And without further ado, let's get started, shall we? Now I know that when it comes to fashion, there are no rules. That's what makes it so fun, especially handbags. Handbags don't have to be something that's just practical. It could be a conversation piece. It could be a work of art. I totally get that. But I think that many of the items that I'm about to share with you today go beyond all that and into the realm of shock value just for the sake of being obnoxious. And I truly think that many of these brands are trolling us and they are purposely pushing the envelope just to see how much they can get away with because of their name. And they're the ones that are laughing all the way to the bank. So I don't blame them by any means whatsoever, because at the end of the day, they're the ones that end up winning. Why? Because they get you to talk about the item, they get you to visit the boutique to see the item that you're talking about, and in some cases, they also get you to buy something that you weren't even in the market for because you were in the boutique looking at the item that you were talking about. So it's genius. There's no such thing as bad publicity. It's a brilliant marketing move, and many of these brands have perfected it. And I know that this is a very unpopular opinion, but I truly don't blame the brands. I don't blame the brands making them. I blame the consumer that's out there causing such a frenzy for some of these items. Hey, call me crazy, call me what you will, but those are just my two cents. But enough of that. Let's get into these items, because I think that many of us are going to be saying why quite a bit throughout this video. All right, so the first one, the one that really sparked the reasoning behind this video idea, that is the Balenciaga trash pouch slash bag. This guy right here. And trust me, Balenciaga is going to be throughout this video a lot. But this guy right here. So when I first saw it, I legitimately thought it was a joke. I was like, what? What? There's no way. There is no way. And then I started doing a little bit more digging, which obviously wasn't difficult, because this item has caused such a buzz over the last week and a half. And it is absolutely a true thing. It is supposed to resemble a trash bag. It comes in, it's gonna be available in three different colors, black, white, and blue, and it comes in at $1,780 here in the States. So it is 100% a leather trash bag. That is the look they were going for. And this is straight from what the creative director said. I couldn't miss an opportunity to make the most expensive trash bag in the world, because who doesn't love a fashion scandal? Now, we all know that Balenciaga is known for, for these shock value items, for making the most ridiculous items be very fashionable, right? There, like I said, there's quite a few that are gonna be throughout this video. But this one for me takes the cake. Some of the other ones I'm like, okay, they're ridiculous, but I guess I can kind of see it's very like the Balenciaga Paris sneakers, those dirty looking sneakers that look like something that's straight out of Zoolander, you know, the Derelict collection. But this one for me takes the cake, because I'm like, it's a leather trash bag. I mean, even if I were to look at it as a consumer of a handbag lover, I can't even wrap my brain around it. Can you imagine? Let's just pretend for a moment, all right? Let's pretend that we have this bag and we throw all our shit in there. Can you, everything's gonna go down to the bottom. It has no shape to it. I know, Manny, that's what it's supposed to be. I get it, all right? I get it. But like I said, let's just pretend for a moment that it is supposed to be this fabulous bag. It doesn't work. It doesn't work. I can't even imagine lugging this thing around. I mean, you couldn't find anything, you know? But this is absolutely ridiculous. It doesn't have the craziest price point compared to other brands and other bags and stuff like that. But considering that it's supposed to be a leather trash bag, that to me, again, just takes the cake, being beyond ridiculous. It's so insanely stupid. And watch, it's going to sell like crazy. There is no doubt in my mind that it's going to sell like crazy. Let's move on to the next one. The next one is from Bottega. It is the mini pouch mop chenille crossbody bag. this guy right here. So this bag is available in, so far from what I can tell, three different colors: blue, pink, and yellow. And it comes in at $2,350 here in the States. $2,350 here in the States, and it looks like something you would wash your car with. That is insane. Many of the websites that have this item available are low in stock. I was like, what? I thought that I did not expect to see low in stock, only a few left or anything like that. It weighs in approximately it comes in at 1.1 pounds. It has a 25.5-inch crossbody strap. It has the magnetic frame closure, a crossbody strap, as I said before, lambskin leather lining, nylon with leather trim, made in Italy. Why? Why? Just go grab a chamois, or go grab, you know, that mitt to wash your car, put on some leather straps, and boom, there you go. You don't have to spend $2,350. You can spend maybe $5.99. Well, maybe for the leather, who knows, you know, but it looks like something you would wash your car with, for me anyways. I think it's absolutely ridiculous. The colors also, I think, make it so, like, in your face, kind of, in a way. I don't know. But the one that seems to be the most popular is definitely the pink. But yeah, no. It looks like a Muppet. It looks like a toy. It looks like, I mean, I don't know. Am I crazy? Am I in, like, Bizarro World or something? I don't know. But I was like, $2,350 for a wash rag for your car with some leather straps. That is absolutely insane. I guess if you're caught in the rain, you could just dab yourself off and you're good to go, right? The next one got quite a few votes, and it's one that I don't necessarily agree with, but still, it is the Louis Vuitton paint can. Now, the paint can is available in either four or five different colors, if I'm not mistaken. It comes in at $2,850 here in the States. And yes, it is absolutely ridiculous that they took something like a paint can and they turned it into a handbag. It is ridiculous. I completely see that. But at the same time, I personally view this more as a collector's piece. And you guys know it's not because I have, like, mad love for Louis Vuitton, because obviously I can always point out the bad too, or the ugly as well. But I just think that this is more of a collector's piece for a hardcore Louis Vuitton lover. I definitely see this item appreciating in value as the years go by, and it's one that is a conversation starter. It is so out there, it is so ridiculous, but at the same time, they made it very Louis Vuitton-esque. They made it very them, you know? And if Chanel Factory 5 can take paint brushes or paint cans and do the same thing with some plain, ordinary packaging, and those things can sell out, there is no doubt in my mind that these are gonna be popular as well. I've already seen quite a few people on social media that have added these to their collections who are huge Louis Vuitton lovers and huge Louis Vuitton collectors. So, I mean, it's just a matter of finding someone out there that really likes these items. But is it ridiculous? Absolutely. Absolutely. I mean, why don't you throw in a paintbrush in there as well and just make it a whole set? Let's just go balls to the wall with this thing, right? Is it ridiculous? Absolutely. Is it obnoxious? Absolutely. Do I think it's the most ridiculous one on this list? I definitely don't, but hey, to each their own. But yeah, $2,850, way too pricey for a leather paint can, in my opinion. Now, the next one got the most votes when it came to sharing the ugliest or the most ridiculous item on the market right now, besides the Balenciaga trash pouch. That is the Chanel 22 bag. Oh man, you guys were ruthless when it came to this bag, but I don't disagree. I think this is one of the ugliest handbags that's out there right now. I'm not a fan of it. I never have been. To me, it doesn't look like a trash bag. I mean, the larger one is definitely a little bit bigger, but to me, it looks like a leather dust bag. It absolutely looks like a leather dust bag, and the price point that these bags have is absolutely ridiculous, you know? And I know a lot of people would say it's so comfortable, it's so lightweight, that's great, that's awesome. But for me, it's kind of like along the same lines as the Balenciaga one. I can't really wrap my brain around it. It looks like a leather dust bag. just grab a dust bag. Grab a Chanel dust bag. You know, it doesn't have to be leather. It says Chanel on there already. And use that as a handbag. It's the same concept. It just, my voice got all whiny up there. But all it does is it has a little pouch and it has a little charm. That's really the only other thing besides the fact that it's that shiny, what is it, shiny lambskin? Or shiny calfskin. I think there's a variety out there. Yeah, I'm not a fan. Definitely not a fan. I think it is absolutely hideous. It does nothing for me. To me, it just seems like one of those, I don't know, is it like one of those Emperor's New Clothes type of thing? Like, again, am I in Bizarro world? Is there something that I'm just not seeing when it comes to this bag? I don't know. Sometimes I even question my sanity. I'm like, is there something wrong with me? Is it like, you know, because it is such a popular bag, even though it's ugly. For me, a lot of people absolutely adore this bag. But yeah, I'm not a fan. Like, stupid expensive as well for all the sizes that it's available in. Oh, they will make anything. As long as it says Chanel, it'll sell like crazy. So I don't get it. I don't get it. This bag is not for me. It's no. Absolutely not. It looks like a leather dust bag, don't you think? Absolutely. Like I said before, just grab a dust bag. It already has the drawstrings on there. Throw your stuff in there and you're out the door. It's a handbag and it says Chanel. You're good to go. You're good to go. The next item is from Balenciaga and that is the Crocs large tote bag. From what I can see, it's available in three different colors. There might be more out there. Pink, black, and green. It comes in at $1,250 here in the States. $1,250 for a rubber tote. What is going on? First of all, don't even get me started on Crocs. I think I'm the only person on the planet that thinks that those are some of the ugliest shoes out there. I don't care if they're comfortable. It does not matter to me. I think they are absolutely atrocious. They do not appeal to me whatsoever. And now you want to turn it into a hand, you want to turn it into a bag? I mean, it goes to show that people will buy anything. Just, it depends on the name. If you're a big Crocs fan, you love the shoes, why wouldn't you get the tote? It makes perfect sense. Then you have the matching set. I don't know. I don't understand. Is it comfortable for your shoulder? I mean, it's breathable, right? I don't know. It is a rubber toe. It's just Crocs. It's Crocs. And I'm sure there's someone out there saying that this is the greatest thing since sliced bread. Oh my gosh, it's amazing. I don't know. It's pretty large. It's 17 by 15 by 10 rubber tote bag, top handles, open top. Balenciaga logo, debossed tone on tone at front, perforated at front and back, wipe with a soft cloth. Hey, if you get any dirt on there, clean it right off. You don't have to, you could even put a hose to it. You know, you don't have to worry about conditioner. You don't have to worry about cleaner. It's very easy to keep clean. So maybe that's what's so appealing about it. Who knows? Speaking of Crocs, this video cannot be completed without, oh yeah, you guessed it, the Balenciaga, the matching Balenciaga Crocs Madam Mules. Check these babies out. Oh, aren't they divine? They are absolutely beautiful. Oh my God. Where have these shoes been all of my life? Not only do I love Crocs, but I mean the fact that you made them into heels so that way I can wear them with my Crocs tote is a slam dunk. Said no one ever. They're $625. They're available in pink, black, green, and white. There might be more out there. I don't know. But they are also causing a buzz on social media. I've seen people that have worn socks with them and they're like, look at the, they're amazing. And then I look at the comments and people are like, oh my God, so chic, so fashionable. Where are Crocs with socks that have heels on them, fashionable? My brain is going to explode. Oh my God. These are absolutely hideous. Hideous. But again, if you want to match your Croc tote with some Croc socks, or with some socks and some Croc heels, this is it. This is amazing. It's just, absolutely floored. I can imagine just the oohing and aahing that must have been during the runway with these shoes. They're absolutely fantastic, and I'm sure they are exquisitely, exquisitely comfortable as well. So these are amazing, right? These are absolutely amazing. Speaking of ugly and atrocious shoes, we also have to include the dad sandal phenomenon. Oh yeah, be it Chanel, be it Prada. I mean, it feels like every single fashion house out there has their play on the dad sandal. Now, again, I might be the only person on the planet that despises, and I know that's a harsh word, but despises the dad sandal. I don't get it. I think they're hideous. They're right up there with, and I'm sure I'm gonna get the eye rolls right now, Birkenstocks. I cannot stand those shoes either. They have never been for me. And trust me, I have tried them on because people are like, oh my God, they're so comfortable. They're so this or they're so that. I tried on the Birkenstocks and I'm like, I don't get it. I don't get it at all. And I think that these dad sandals are right up there as well. And the prices that some of these dad sandals have are out of this world. I mean, Chanel probably takes the cake, right? Because you have some that are like $2,000, $2,500 on the pre-loved market. Don't even get me started on the pre-loved market. They're even more expensive on the pre-loved market because some styles are hard to find. And I'm sure they're super comfortable. I've heard a lot of people say that they're amazing. They're so comfortable. I can wear them for hours, no blisters. I wear them with socks as well. I mean, I've heard it all. That's awesome. I mean, more power to you, but for me, these are right up there with some of the ugliest shoes on the planet. So that's the Crocs, Birkenstocks, and the whole dad sandal thing going on. It has never, ever appealed to me. I don't get it. I even tried on some of the dad sandals. I mean, my foot looks bulbous and it's, I don't know. It'll be interesting to see what people think about these fashions 10 years from now. And I wonder if people are like, oh my, what was I thinking? What was I thinking? You know, again, I go back to the whole thing. It's like everyone says it's amazing. So do you have to say it's amazing because everyone else says it's amazing? And if you don't say it's amazing, you look like you have a third eye on your forehead. You know, that's what I feel like whenever I voice my opinion about the whole dad sandal and Birkenstock and Croc thing. I get some crazy, crazy comments. People are like, you don't even know, Minnie, blah, blah, blah. Cool, man. If it, do you. You do you. But for me, some of the ugliest shoes, and some of the Chanel shoes have Velcro on them. Yeah, Velcro. And you want to charge over $2,000 for some shoes that have Velcro? Come on, dude. Like, again, it goes to show people will buy anything just because of the name. I sound like such a bitter Betty, but I promise I'm not. It's just, hey, if we said that we were going to roast or we were going to talk about these items, that's exactly what we're doing. We're not holding back any punches. I had to include these in there as well. Are you ready? These next items are from a brand that is very near and dear to my heart. It's one of my first loves when it comes to handbags. I am talking about Coach. So Coach recently launched one of their newest lines, which is called Coach Coachies. Yeah, you heard that correctly. Coach Coachies. They have a few different handbags as well as small leather goods, and I think they are absolutely insane. Not only do I think that they're overpriced, but I think that considering what they look like, they shouldn't have these price points either. And no, it gets better. It gets better. Meet Dreamy, Sweetie, Sparky, Winky, and Groovy, aka the Coachies. These personalities are a part of Coach's new limited edition fall collection of the cutest handbags packed with personality. The Coachies line include card holders, crossbody bags. Each piece has a set of animated eyes with colorful detailing on a bold and vibrant backdrop. The handbags are accessorized with turn locks, tassels, zipper tabs, and other cutesy charms and details that give the appearance of hands and legs. Yeah, because that's what you want, right? You want something that looks like it's living or whatever to carry on your arm. Plus, some of these pieces are made with recycled materials. This collection has a piece for every vibe. It's fun, playful, and eccentric in the chicest way. These expressive bags will steal the spotlight, and you have to be okay with that. Oh my, I love Coach, all right? You guys know it's one of my first loves when it comes to handbags. And I'm so happy that they were able to turn everything around and that they were back on top when it came to contemporary brands. But this is definitely not it. I mean, the fact that you made something so that it resembles a face and then you have arms and, like, why? Arms and legs? Again, we go back to, like, stuffed animals or... I don't know. Cutesy, fun, playful. I have a vibe, and this is definitely not my vibe, you know? And the prices for some of the bags are $950. You want to charge $950 for a face? There's no way. I don't care who you are, you know? This kind of also reminds me of Fendi when they did the whole monster, the monster line or what have you. I mean, those sold like crazy. And there's no doubt in my mind that these will sell like crazy as well. Because as it said, it's limited edition, it's very popular. But I just, $950 is way, way too much for something that looks like that. $300 is too much for something that looks like that. I don't know. I mean, I get enough from my Celine luggage tag that I think looks like a robot. You know, has that little face. But this actually legitimately, purposely has eyeballs to make it look like a face. At least that one is kind of hidden and it's kind of inconspicuous, you know. But this one is like, hey, I'm a face. I got arms. I got legs. Check me out. No, absolutely. Absolutely not. Now this next item to me is a slap in the face, and it takes a fashion house being lazy to a whole different level. And I am talking about the Fendi Baguette embroidery kit. Now this embroidery kit is available in one size only, and it comes in at $32.90 here in the States. The fact that they are giving you the materials for you to create your own bag, and they still have the audacity to charge $32.90 for a partial bag, absolutely blows my mind. They're even saying that, you know, this unique kit comes with its very own embroidery kit containing different colored cotton threads as well as needles and thimbles. Get embroidering and add your own personal touch to create a bag that is truly one of a kind. I get that. I totally get that. But why not have someone create that at the boutique or online, and then you make it, then you can charge the $32.90, and then all's well, right? But instead, you want to charge that crazy price point and have someone make it there. It's like, why don't you just make a kit for like 10 grand that has all the leather pieces and say, here, you want a Fendi bag, you create it and have fun with it. Go for it. You know, it just absolutely blows my mind. Next up are the Balenciaga Defenders. I talked about these on Instagram a couple of weeks ago, and I was blown away by these shoes, and I thought there is no way that these are popular. There is no way that anybody in their right mind is buying these sneakers. And I was so, so wrong. I've seen three people while I've been out and about wearing these sneakers, and I was absolutely floored. I had nothing to say because I was wrong. Obviously, again, there's something for everybody, but these Defender sneakers are available in a variety of different colors. I've seen black, they have beige, gray, a few others, and they come in at $1,150. I have always wanted sneakers that look like tires. Not only that, they give you a little bit of height as well, because who doesn't want a little bit more height? I know I do. You know, I come in at 5'5", so I'm always grateful for a little bit more height. But these, the fact that I can run on the street. I can hit the freeway. I don't have to worry because I have enough tread on my feet when it comes to these sneakers. Aren't they amazing? And I'm a sneakerhead till the day that I die, but these are absolutely, absolutely hideous. The red carpet collection, the Defender is super chunky sneaker with extreme tire tread. Again, oh, these are Balenciaga definitely takes the cake when it comes to shock value, kind of like what we talked about before. They are pushing the envelope. They are pushing it and pushing it and pushing it. And so far, they haven't met an end because their items sell. Their items, you know, they're buzzworthy. It doesn't matter. If people don't like them, or if they do, they're talking about them. Check out this video. I don't like any of these items, but here I am making a video about them as well. So, you know, I'm no better either. But yeah, those shoes are insane. And last but not least, I'm probably gonna get the most hate for this, but that's okay. We have to discuss the fuzzy sandals from Hermes. Oh yeah, Hermes has a couple different fuzzy sandals ranging from $860 to $990. And they are wool skin on the top and leather. They have a leather sole or a leather bottom. Now, I have seen these on social media so much over the last 2 weeks. Many of the colors are already sold out. This is another item that I personally just don't get. It's kind of right up there with the Gucci Princetown loafers that had all the fur. I didn't like those either, and I feel like these are kind of the same thing. Although these are, they're not sand, they're slippers. They are legit house slippers with a $1,000 price point. Do I expect anything less from Hermes? Definitely not. I've heard some people say that they're crazy comfortable, and I don't disagree. I'm sure that they're very comfortable, but they're still like, they're house slippers, you know, and they're $1,000 for wool and leather. It's just absolutely insane to me. Plus, I'm not really a big fan of the whole, of the fuzzy texture when it comes to handbags either, handbags or shoes. So it's definitely not my, jam. It's not my thing. But I thought that $1,000 for some wool and leather house slippers is just, it's beyond like that. I have no words. All right, you guys, so that does it for our video. I could easily make a part 2, part 3, part 4 with all of the feedback that I got on both of those platforms, but I don't want to make this video too long. But these are the ones that definitely that people commented about the most, so that's why I wanted to include them in this video. But it is just absolutely crazy. And look, as I've said before, whatever makes you happy, go for it. It doesn't matter what anybody says. If any of these items are your jam, absolutely go for it. Who cares what anybody thinks, you know? And as I said before, when it comes to fashion, there are no rules. Can you imagine how boring this life would be if everybody liked the same things? It would be terrible. The fact that so many people, that so many of us have different opinions and have different styles is what makes fashion so incredibly amazing, you know, that no two people necessarily have the same taste. Who cares what anybody thinks? If it's your jam, absolutely go for it. But these were just my opinions on these handbags. I didn't want to hold back. I wanted to give you guys the full, you know, exactly what I felt about them when I saw them. Of course, I had to keep it a little PG. With everything that we saw in today's video and everything else that's out there that we didn't get a chance to cover, I don't think it's too far-fetched to say that in the future, I wholeheartedly think that we are going to see a fashion house or a designer literally take shit, wrap it up in tin foil, add a brooch to it, slap their name on it, and sell it for $1,000 and say that this is the greatest thing to happen to jewelry since diamonds. I don't think that's crazy to say. We have seen crazier things before, you know? But again, these are just my two cents. But I would love to know, what are some other things that you think are ridiculously overpriced or absolutely hideous, you know, on the market right now, be it luxury or contemporary goods? But as I said previously, you do you. I'm not the most fashionable person on the planet. You guys know that. I am very, very plain Jane. Beauty is in the eye of the beholder. And for now, and during this video, these eyeballs are the ones that are looking at these items, and I am definitely not impressed. But either way, I would love to hear your thoughts on everything that we discussed and on any other items that you think are absolutely overpriced, ugly, you name it, whatever the case may be, let us know in the comment section down below. But I hope that you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, make sure and give it a thumbs up. If you haven't already and you would like to, please subscribe to my YouTube channel, and I'll see you guys later. And as always, make it a fabulous day or not, the choice is yours. Have a great day.